Star Michael Ball will be a household name. He's already recorded the theme song from the show and it's zooming up the charts, and I think it's going to be a number one hit. He's absolutely brilliant and I went down to see him in rehearsal.
Let's do it again. Right, if you take it back to the top of the song,
yeah,
and we'll go up to
the
key change.
With conviction.
Love changes everything, hands and faces, earth and sky. Love changes everything, how you live and how you die. Love can make the summer fly, or a night seem like a lifetime. Yes, love changes everything. Now I tremble at your name. Nothing in the world will ever be the
There isn't an overture as such, which you normally have at the beginning of a musical. I open it on the stage on my own, and it's really... It says everything about what you're going to see in the show, about the effect that love has on people and on relationships and so on.
This isn't your first part, though, is it, in the West End?
No. Last year, I just finished doing Phantom of the Opera. I took over as Raoul. And prior to that, I was doing Les Miserables, playing Marius, which was my first job in the West End, only my second job, really.
This amazing voice you've got hasn't been trained, has it?
Something, I mean, I've always sung. My family are very musical. They're a great Welsh background. My uncle sings with a male voice choir, that kind of thing. So I've always been surrounded by music and always sung. But it's never been trained. And I, to be honest, when I first started off in the business and at drama school, I never thought I'd use it. It was just something I loved to do. And to be able to make money doing what you love to do is marvellous.
Does the thought of having to fill the Prince of Wales Theatre frighten you?
We've got a huge advance already, about $2.5 million. And some people say, well, it's a guaranteed success, but not at all. There are people who have booked their tickets who have heard nothing and know nothing about the show and are expecting it to be the best show in London, and we are gonna endeavour to do that. But I mean it's a hell of a responsibility.
When did you first hear this song?
Love Changes Everything. Must have been in last May or June, just before we started work for the Sidmonton Festival. And as soon as I heard it, I thought, this is a fabulous tune, fabulous. And then having heard the rest of the score, I couldn't believe it. He's done it again. He's got a magnificent score, wonderful lyrics by Don Black and Charlie Hart. It's up to us now. We've got to do something with it.
It's one of the finest voices that's come on the scene for the last 20 years. I also think he's interesting because not since Tom Jones, I think, has someone come along who could explode on the scene. He's young, he's 26, he has a fine voice, an ingredient we haven't seen lately in pop music. People don't usually talk about great singers these days, they talk about great records. I think Michael could change that.
Isn't he something else? He's such a nice bloke as well. I mean, you've all got to go and get tickets. You mustn't miss it. Did you hear that,
And you
Richard?
Really can't go wrong Michael. With a fabulous song like that, can you? Oh. Mind you, that poor chap's got an awful lot on his shoulders.